circular economy really is an economic model. So it looks at the whole system. It's not a question of having a plugin that says we can operate in the same linear fashion and have better optimized material flows. It's not recycling, it's much wider than that.
Hello and welcome to the Bio4 channel. My name is Karina Cella. In this program, we will be talking about circular economy and how we should develop our economy and redesign our production cycles. Joining us here at the Bio4 studio is Esa Laurinsilta. Welcome, Esa.
Hello. Thank you, Karina.
How would you define in two or three words what is circular economy?
Well, putting anything into two words is pretty tough. I would say circular economy as such is a good term, having two words. But in the UPM context, I would really say resource efficiency.
Our first interviewee is from the Ellen MacArthur Foundation. What can you tell us about that foundation?
Well, Ellen MacArthur Foundation is really a great non-profit foundation, really an organization that has really raised up the awareness for circular economy and really that we cannot put all that waste, all that plastic waste in the oceans and really to utilize, how to utilize better the our resources and really get rid of waste.
So let's go to Brussels and listen to our first guest, Jocelyn Bleriot, and his thoughts on circular economy.
We see a lot of uptake of the concept, both from the private sector and the public sector, and there's growing understanding and acceptance of the fact that we need to redefine the way we look at economic growth and see it from a positive point of view. So there's quite a lot of hope, actually, that things are picking up. It needs to scale now, because it's picking up, but it's still too small. But there are elements to be enthusiastic about.
Esa, what do you think about Bleriot's statements about circular economy?
Well, I think one of the key issues that he mentions there is that we certainly do need a systemic change to really change how we look at manufacturing, how do we look at generating waste, and especially that we actually design products so that we eliminate the waste or at least create waste as little as possible. And that there's a very strong link also for our company with this kind of eco design approach that we have had a number of years that try to develop processes and products so that we use as little resources as possible. We have been really in this kind of a circular economy mode for a number of years. And take going back to just recycling the paper, the newspaper material, that's one area, but also that having such huge volumes of in the production processes that the different kind of circular loops or closed loops, for example, water use, utilization of the fiber. So in that sense, we have had a strong focus on resource efficiency, which really has a very strong link with circular economy thinking.
And now let's go to a field trip.
So the benefits of using sludges is that the right place for such kind of sludges is that they can be recycled and crops can utilize these nutrients they are in these sludges. And then there are also organic matter in these sludges, and that's a benefit for soil microbiological activity and also somehow in the soil structure. So the right place is fields, not burning them or doing some landfill with them.
Esa, Yara is a well-known fertilizer manufacturer. What more can you tell us about them?
Well, I would like to emphasize, of course, Yara being such an expert on actual crop and plant nutrition. So really looking at it holistically. And that's one of the big reasons why we are very happy to work with them.
And tell us a bit more about this research you have with them.
In our manufacturing processes, we also generate huge volumes of side streams and even waste. And so, like the sludges that go through the wastewater treatment, they do contain nutrients. So this is something what we are looking at, how to take up those nutrients and utilize them in in fertilizing products.
Raflatac is known for its pioneer work in the field of recycling and in how to take a leap into circular economy. Let's hear how Raflatac is working with Cielo e Terra, a wine producer in Italy.
We meet at the end of 2012 UPM with this project with Rafcycle. And so we were one of the first company in Italy that we put together the efforts with UPM and take the Rafcycle project as our project in circular economy. We collect this liner, and UPM take this liner, this waste, because it was a waste, but now it's not a waste because UPM take this liner and transform it in new products, in new paper, in new packaging materials, or in building materials.
Isaac, could you summarize what is circular economy for UPM, and how do you see the future effect of that?
Well, I would say that, of course, we will continue on this resource efficiency and eco-design approach. But we still have a lot of things to be optimized, and there we certainly need partners and partnerships how to reach that goal.
So partners are extremely important then for this whole process?
Yes, exactly. And I think Rafcycle is a good example of this kind of bringing also the service element. The other one is that we are looking for this kind of industrial symbiosis, partners to come into our sites and utilizing certain site streams or certain waste streams and then creating new business out of that. Something that it's not in the UPM focus, but together we can create something new and valuable.
And what does circular economy mean to us, to the people, to society?
Well, I think I would go back to Josh Bleriot's comment that we do need this systemic change, that we do need to start thinking differently, that we actually need all the things that we have. How much can we reuse, recycle, and in that sense, rethink?
Thank you, Esa, for being with us.
Thank you, Karina. It was good to be here.
Great. Circular economy is all about rethinking, redesigning and creating value. And one thing has become very clear today, there's no such thing as waste. Thank you for joining us.